As most of you know, last time where we left off, CaliKim posted her first vlog on the iPhone, and then that her next one we did using my camera, right?
Yeah, your fancy camera.
The fancy camera, and not bad, but it was a lot of work. It was.
It's kind of hard for me to figure out.
And it was bulky.
I don't know.
Right.
It's a little awkward.
Right.
For me anyway, because I'm no expert.
Right. It's very manual. I remember saying that.
Yeah.
And again, not a bad thing, but just it wasn't grab and go for you.
No.
We tried it.
Right. Film that video. You guys don't even want to know.
That's true. Okay. So by the suggestion of one of our viewers, Mickey J 2005 suggested, hey, why don't you get one of these Canon Elfs? And honestly, I had forgotten about those Canon Elfs and just the smaller compact point and go kind of digital cameras. They shoot video and pictures, etc. And so thanks to Mickey J for that thought, because I had forgotten about those, was a little bit concerned about the audio on those. And so I picked up something similar, was able to get a great price on it, on a Sony camera. So we're gonna unbox it tonight, again, thanks to Mickey J, but I really think it's gonna be really helpful for CaliKim. It's gonna make her totally mobile to be able to do this.
Looks nice and small. A whole lot smaller than the one that you've got.
Right, so let's go ahead. Yeah, go ahead and open it up. It's. I opened it just to make sure everything was in there, but let's check it out. Let's see what we have. I think this is really going
to
be...
Wi-Fi connection guide? You can connect it to Wi-Fi?
Yeah, these... Wow. I didn't even know that, but these little compact cameras now are Wi-Fi.
Wow.
And apparently what they can do is send the photos to your smartphone. It's incredible.
So you can post on Instagram and Facebook and stuff like that?
Well, not right from the camera, but it can get right to your smartphone.
Oh,
and then,
cool.
Boom, you just upload it to either your what's it called, Instagram page.
Wow.
I don't know what it does with video, but so anyway.
That is cool. So this takes stills as well as video.
Yep. So
this is really cool.
All right.
I think
well,
it's charged up or no?
And hit the power button if you can find it. I didn't even really look at it. I mean, I read reviews.
Ooh. What was that? Some kind of noise.
I read reviews on this, 1080p, 60 frames per second. Good enough. We don't want to get complicated. But 1080p is a good quality of video.
You're not speaking my language yet.
HD. So that's good. Keeping it simple.
Okay, turned it on. Is it supposed to open the
I haven't
shutter?
A clue.
It's called the shutter, right?
No.
Oh.
It's just called the lens cap.
The lens
or
cap.
The lens cover.
Maybe there's a lens
cap. No, just.
Sorry. I don't want to mess it up already.
Okay.
I'm going to let you do it there.
Okay. Let's.
He's the camera guy. I'm the gardening girl.
All right. Let's do this. Selects camera display color. Okay. CaliKim's favorite color is red. I'm just telling you that right now in case you send her Christmas gifts. Favorite color is red. If you haven't noticed.
I'll always want red.
Yeah, well, this looks a little bit goofy red to me, but we'll deal with it later.
Yeah, we can figure that all out. Well, this is really nice.
Well, it's really simple.
It has a memory card, too.
Oh, hey, look at
there
that.
Hi.
Look at that.
Hi, everyone.
Oh,
it's CaliKim. I think I'm going to have fun with this, guys.
Here, you hold it. What do you think?
Nice. It looks... Well, your camera, when I look through it, especially mm-hmm. inside, mm-hmm. the lighting was always kind of funny.
Because it's a manual, right?
Right. So this one already I can see.
Okay.
It's actually a decent light.
All right,
inside.
Cool.
I don't have to really adjust it, so.
All right. We got a little microphone. I think that will enhance this. This is a stereo microphone, so you'll have CaliKim in stereo.
Take a picture of the camera that's filming us right now.
Well, you need a card in there. And I don't think you have that.
Cool.
Now you have a memory card in there, so wait and see what it does. Tracking
okay.
focus, that's incredible.
What does that mean?
That means it'll lock in on you, and then you will, it'll track with you if you move around on the screen. It'll stay focused on you automatically, which, by the way, nice. My camera, the Canon 7D, does not do that. And so that's why you guys may have noticed in some of our videos that I'm constantly going in and out of focus, because I'm manually having to focus the minute the person walks forward or backward or in and out of the shot. So this will stay automatic with you.
Huh. Okay.
And I have a cute little, I can't believe I just said that. I have a little tripod for you, and you can just set that in the grass or, you know, wherever you are, or you can, you know, you can do this, like.
Do you like a selfie kind of thing?
Right.
Push this button like this.
Right. And so we'll figure out how to record. Very cool. So there it is again. Thanks to Mickey. What was his name?
Mickey J 2005.
Sorry about that. Mickey J 2005. Thanks for reminding me about these smaller compact cameras.
Okay. Is it recording?
Yeah.
Is there any blinking light or anything?
It's on the other side.
On the back side, oh, there okay. should be, right?
Yeah.
I can't see it when I'm shooting myself.
Is it blinking red on the back?
Yeah, it is.
Cool.
Okay, guys. I'm just trying out this new camera. It's really, really cool. It's so lightweight. It's going to be so much easier, don't you think, Drew? I think I'm going to be able to film a lot more videos because I have this thing and it's just so easy to hold. This little microphone that hooks on top that Camera Guy just showed you, it has like a bi-directional little thing that you can change. This is really cool. So bear with me while I get used to it, but I am really excited about it. What do you think? You'll be able to use it too.
Cool.
Maybe you can actually help me shoot some videos too when Dad's at work and stuff before he gets home after school and everything. What do you think?
No.
No? What do you mean no? Aren't you really excited to run camera for me?
No.
Well, hopefully once he gets a look at this thing, he'll be a little more excited. But you know what? Dad said he actually had something else that he brought home for me.
Oh, cool.
So let's go see what it is. Can't wait.
Okay, here it is.
Oh boy.
Tim and Lisa.
What is that?
Tim and Lisa said they wanted to give you this.
Really?
They said you guys were talking about trees or something.
Yeah, a few weeks ago I forgot about it.
Yeah,
she said it was a plum tree that they didn't need in their yard. So yeah.
Come on.
Okay. Oh my gosh, I'm totally trying to get more fruit trees in the yard, so I'm really excited about that. I don't really know if it's a regular sized tree or a dwarf tree. There goes the dog.
What do you think?
Wow, that's cool. This is pretty cool. Now I gotta find a space for it, but we'll figure it out.
You like it?
I do. Looks a little bit dry, but hey, it looks like it'll come back pretty well. I think it'll be great. You know what? I wonder if we should maybe put it in the front yard.
Front yard?
What do you think?
I don't know, we're kind of
running out of space back here.
Yeah, but, okay, I don't know, I thought you wanted them all in the back.
I don't know. I'm just kind of thinking out loud, the front yard has lots of sun, and we need something in the front, it's not that pretty.
Yeah, our front yard's pretty hurting.
It's kind of hurting.
But don't you need a place to put it in the front yard?
Well, you just kind of have to make a little, you know, tree. Like those little circles, plastic circles that you have the tree and dig out an area. I don't know. We'll have to think about it.
Yeah.
But we've got a lemon tree to plant.
I was going to say, a grapevine to plant.
And I want more fruit trees too, so. We don't have any more space back here.
Yeah.
We need to take those cypress trees out behind the fountain and plant trees back there.
Could we? Those cypress trees are horrible.
They're so ugly and they just have a lot of spiders. They're just like, they're a pain. Don't ever plant cypress trees. Possibly. I don't know, guys. We'll give it some thought. We'll figure it out. It'll be a new CaliKim episode at some point or another, I'm sure. But yeah, this thing's great. I'll have to ask her if it's like a full-size tree or a dwarf tree. Oh, I'm so excited. A free tree.
That's
you can't beat that.
Very nice of them to do that.
Yeah, really nice.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Well, you know what? Actually, while we're talking, I am going to call Brian and see if I can borrow his chainsaw, because we got to get going on that this weekend anyway, right?
Oh yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, So.
We actually have a semi-free Saturday. We could probably knock it out this weekend. Right. Get that tree taken out and get the lemon tree planted.
Voicemail.
Oh. Say hi, Mac.
If we can get it sometime before.
Yeah.
Hey, Brian, it's Jerry calling. How's it going, bud? Listen, I remember you said you had a chainsaw, right? Because you kind of went to town with it in your backyard. Well, I was wondering if I could use it this weekend, Saturday afternoon. Maybe I can get it from you earlier, and then I would use it Saturday afternoon and bring it back to you Sunday afternoon or something. All right, Brian, thanks. Let me know. Talk to you later. Bye. All right, well, we'll see what he says. We'll start. We'll do that this Saturday afternoon.
Okay.
I forget the guy's name on YouTube who commented about how to remove the tree.
Yeah, I'll have to look that up, but he had a really good suggestion.
But he said, don't pull it out because you're going to end up with a big hole. And he said, cut it down as close as you can to the ground. Then he said something about doing checker patterns.
Yeah.
And then he said something about, then you bury it or something. You cover it up or something. And so anyhow, I was going to go with his suggestion. I'll have to look it up. And we can give him a shout out too.
Yeah, we had a lot of really good suggestions. And that one I remember was a good one because he said that with that checkerboard pattern,
yeah,
then covering it up.
Watch where you're filming to make sure you're not filming people's knees.
That checkerboard pattern and then covering it up would help it break down over time.
Right.
A lot better than just leaving the flat stump.
Right.
So yeah, I thought that was a really good one too.
Yeah, so that's my plan with that.
Yeah,
and then have you found out like how far it needs to be from the fence?
The lemon tree, you mean?
Yeah.
No, it's a dwarf, so probably if we planted about where that stump is, it would be okay, is what I'm thinking. Because the dwarf tree, you can kind of trim to the size that you want. So I'm thinking about where the stump is. But we can look at it. I'll do a little more research, read over the comments again, but we had so many good suggestions, so that will really help. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, okay.
So, you know what? I'd like to get the kids out helping us with that because that's going to be a pretty big job.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll get them out here and, you know, I'll have to turn to the chainsaw possibly. I know, yeah. I'd like definitely like to work the chainsaw. So what do you think about that?
Oh, it's going to be great.
Yeah.
It'll be great on film too.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
You know, with you running the chainsaw, we could have fun with that. And okay, that's good. We've got a busy weekend and... So now we have a plum tree and a lemon tree, right? What's the other one you want?
And the grapevine. We could plant
right,
the grapevine too.
You want another kind of tree?
Yeah, I mean, I eventually want to add like some, you know, like pears, apples, peaches,
yeah,
oranges,
right.
All kinds of stuff. So you can see why I'm going to run out of room real quick here.
Okay, very cool.
So, okay. Well.
All right, sounds good.
Anything else?
No.
Okay. I'm actually going to go get started on dinner.
Yeah, I'm kind of shaky. I'm hungry.
And, yeah, I'm going to make some burritos with homemade refried beans. And I'm going to grill up some eggplant. So maybe I get a quick little shot of that.
Eggplant with burrito?
Wait till you taste it. Grilled eggplant.
Sounds good.
Okay.
All right. I think I am, anyway.
I'm gonna throw this on the grill. I had another eggplant today that I picked. This one was a lot bigger than the last one. Look at these big slices. Put it on the grill, chop it up, put it in burritos. It's gonna be yummy. Okay, guys, this grill is hot, hot, hot. I love to hear the sizzle. Look at that. I am not the best griller in the world. In fact, I would say I'm a lousy griller because I go in the house and do other things, and by the time I get back out here, my meat or whatever I have on the grill has burned. So I'm gonna babysit these guys so they don't turn into mush here on the grill. But be patient. So I'm gonna put them in my burritos tonight. I'll come back and show you when they're nice and grilled up. Okay, these are looking really good, guys. Oh no, one fell through the crack. Oh my gosh, what a bummer. Okay, I told you guys I'm not the best griller. Oh dear, look at this, it got burned while I was trying to figure this darn camera out. Oh no, Okay, I gotta get these off. Okay, these are over here on the searing burner. It's harder than it looks. Are definitely done. I'm gonna move them up to the top. Wow, these look so good, but I'm bummed about the one that fell through. Okay, what I wanted to show you, I gotta figure this thing out here, how you hold this darn camera for selfies. My daughter's always telling me I don't know how to take selfies. Okay, a little bit more blackened than I would like, but hey, blackened is good. I think when things are blackened on the grill, it brings out the sweetness. Now, if I could just get it right, I need to practice more is what I need to do. These look fabulous. I cannot wait to try them. I better pay attention to my eggplant or they're gonna be completely terrible. Okay, so we'll see you guys later. Okay guys, last shot here for this video. Look at this eggplant. Turned out delicious. Oh my gosh, I gotta take a bite. Gotta take a quick bite. How am I gonna turn this camera around and take a bite at the same time? Here we go, ready?
Good?
Try a bite. Oh yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's good.
Yeah. I'm gonna chop it up, put it in the burritos. Or do you want it on the side?
Do whatever you feel.
Maybe I'll do both.
Well, that's good to me. I'll just take that whole piece.
Okay. All right, guys, thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.